Every year on 10th of October, World Health Organization celebrates World Mental Health Day. They have a themes to create awareness of the psychological issues in the community. This year's theme is suicide prevention. In the world, every 40 seconds, someone loses their life to suicide. Findings are unbelievable, but it's true. Every second, someone is losing their life. When we hear someone committed suicide, our reaction would be suicide. Our instant thought would be why? What went wrong? Would it have been avoided? The underlying emotion could be painful, with surprise, confusing, helpless. The feelings are very difficult to express, depending on the type of relationship we share with that person. Suicide takes a very heavy toll on the individual, family, and the community around. If you see the statistics worldwide, there are largely the men die of suicide at much higher rate than women. Even the report of unsuccessful attempts are largely seen in the adolescent girls and boys equally. But nowadays, even the age is lowering in teens. Who are most vulnerable to this? It has been observed, commonly the female gender, the person with a low educational attainment, employment, living alone, the history of socioeconomic deprivation, and the patient having chronic illnesses are more chances to pass through this state. Even the caregiver of such people are also fall into this category, having taken care of such a person for a long time without any success. The history of a prior episode of or a prior attempt of suicide is also an important risk factor to commit suicide. So, what are the reasons? What are the causes for this suicide to act? Why one thinks for such an extreme step to decide to end his life? The suicide behaviors are complex. It is very difficult to understand how one takes the decision to end his life and commit a suicide. There are multiple factors responsible for that. It's an interplay of a biological, psychological, social, and environmental factors. There are many factors which are pressing the people from facing the adversities in their life, like poverty, unemployment, family instability, various health issues, which includes depression, substance abuse. Mainly, the fear of failure is the most commonly we have seen in majority of the victims. Be it be an interpersonal relationship, business, work, job area, exam, where success is expected as an outcome. Some of the psychiatric cases like hallucinations are very common in schizophrenia. The delusions which make the individual to think. I would like to share one case from Anukampa ward where we treated one case of suicide. She is a 40-year-old female having two daughters and husband. She landed into ICU in a very bad state. This was her second attempt. The first attempt was practiced when she came to know about an entry of another woman in husband life. They both are well educated, stable, and having good relationship. And theirs was the love marriage. It was against of the parents, so it was naturally the parents did not support their marital life or any help was extended to them. So this entry of a second woman has produced a lot of insecurity in this woman. The way they both started quarreling, the dispute started occurring, and the first attempt was practice only to threaten the husband what to the extent she can go. But that did not change the husband's behavior at all. Hence, after some time, the second attempt was practiced. Now you will see, what is the role of homeopath in this situation when actually the act has been committed? We, the homeopath, we fall into the category of a family physician, the concept which is disappearing from the current world. People come, people express, they discuss their concern, they share their issue with the great faith. But how this will be helpful in the management of society? What role we are going to play when the act is already committed? We see the final act of commission, but for the individual to land in the state of helplessness has begun quite early in individual's life before the final act. He or she may have underwent series of negative experiences, negative emotions without ventilation, without any proper outcome of or without any motivating support, and eventually developed a fixed idea that there is no way to end his life. So, what role we can define for ourselves? It is important to know that most of the people who engage in the suicide behavior are ambivalent about and wanting to die. And the suicide can be an impulsive response to the acute stresses. Being a homeopath, we know the temperament of the individual, its action-reaction phenomena, and its result on psyche of an individual. We can predict the propensities of the responses to various stresses by studying his dispositional qualities, certain defenses used either to protect self or defend. How the individual is going to take up this failure can be predicted by the analysis of his life situation till date. Presence of a genetic and a biological history also adds up to the vulnerability of the reaction and can be prevented by correcting the mental state, the mental condition of the individual, and by correcting the susceptibility. We kept on learning. It is said the prevention is better than cure. We have been learning since the day we enter in medical colleges. But it is important to know the foundation of prevention is to understand what puts a person at risk. I think this is the very crucial role for homeopath to play in this. The understanding the stresses, the understanding the temperament, understanding how the reactions will be thrown by the individual, definitely we as a homeopath can prevent. Since the homeopath has a sound knowledge of mind and its intricacies, and do not require a special knowledge of any other field. So, as a homeopath, we can work on a basic plan of action which comprises of creating awareness of a psychological issues. We definitely can make aware that individual what are the difficulties he is currently going on and what likely the outcome of it. We can identify, we can intervene, and we can prevent such a mishap. Many times it has seen stigma get attached if anybody in the family has committed suicide. So definitely that can be prevented or that can be reduced by talking to that person. Even by letting the person know ki he is not alone plays a great role in changing the mental state of that individual. And it's another opportunity simply to show how he is being care of. The 40 seconds are very, very important in prevention of suicide. How that will be done? Whenever you are understanding the person has having a suicidal ideation or the state which is not good for his further work, you can start conversing with him. It is said that half the case, well taken case, is half cured. So by starting communicating with about his issues, about his this underlying stresses, that definitely will help in diluting the suicide ideation. During the talk, you can send a positive message, you can motivate him, you can encourage him to see the other side of the life. So at the same time, you have to be very empathetic, and you have to send a message, you are all the time available to him. At the same time, you have to follow a very important thing, which is you have to respect his privacy. Whatever the patients are sharing with us, that needs to be limited to you only. I think that is the reason the people, they open up with the homeopaths. Now come back to case. What we have done in that case, we did a simple thing. After knowing her various temperamental issues, the husband-wife relationship, and how the first act could not help the lady, we just ask her one simple question, whether this kind of a behavior has helped her in improving their relationship, and you are most sure the answer is no. Rather, after committing this particular attempt, the husband has declared her to be psycho, the family relationship went on getting disturbed furthermore, and hence the second attack. The time was given to this lady to think over it, whatever the limitations she has, how her emotional outbursts are. Even the husband was talked about the various issues, and I think as usual, the scenario has changed. The slogan of WHO for this year is Live Life. And you must have understood by now what role the homeopath will have in this making one life live satisfactorily. Thank you.